Ladies and gentlemen, we direct your attention to the head of the stretch, where Stanley Dancer, Cardigan Bay's driver trainer, is jogging the great champion to the finish line. It was under Stanley Dancer's astute training and sensational driving that Cardigan Bay reached his full potential in this country. Ladies and gentlemen, for the remainder of the ceremonies honoring the great Cardigan Bay, we switch you to trackside and your master of ceremonies near the finish line, Bob Hackett, editor of the Horseman and Fair World, the most respected journal devoted to the standard bred horse. Ladies and gentlemen, Stanley Dancer and the great Cardigan Bay. Take it away, Bob Hackett.
Ladies and gentlemen, with a great deal of pleasure and certainly a wonderful honor to be here to honor the first million-dollar harness horse. I was at Hollywood Park in 1950 when Citation became the first million-dollar horse in racing, and here we are now to retire Cardigan Bay as two great nations. We have the Prime Minister and other honored guests here who we'll introduce in a moment to retire this fine horse, who is the fastest horse ever to race at Yonkers Raceway. You've seen some great ones, you've seen some great races. Never ever did a horse go around this track faster than Cardigan Bay. He's the world's champion in his own country. His Zealand breeding, and he's not a young man. Look at him, he's 12 years old. He's been in this country 4 years. Our first million-dollar horse. I'd like to ask Joe Wiedemann, behind every great horse, there's got to be a caretaker who's had an awful lot to do with his success. Joe, on behalf of Yonkers Raceway, I'd like to present you with this gold stopwatch, something that you can always have and treasure the rest of your life for the wonderful work you've done with this horse.
Thank you very much.
Because the thing that will never, ever be taken away at Cardigan Bay, Joe Wiedemann and Stanley Dancer is a fact. He is our first million-dollar horse. And I would like to ask now the owners of Cardigan Bay, Irving Berkmeyer and the Cardigan Bay owners, to please step forward, take a brief bow, please. These are the gentlemen that brought this horse to this country. We're willing to put up $100,000 to take a chance, and what a wonderful chance it was, our first million-dollar horse. And along with us in this ceremony, we have the chairman of the New York Trotting Commission, Robert Glasser, and commission member, former Attorney General James A. Farley. Mr. Glasser, General Farley, if you'd please step forward.
Now, I'll bring the primers out front center.
Yeah.
We're right.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's with a great deal of honor and a wonderful privilege to me to introduce to this country a gentleman who was at the White House last Wednesday, who will be speaking to the United Nations, the Right Honorable Keith Holyoake, the Prime Minister of New Zealand.
Thank you very much. We have to press the trigger.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I say how very pleased I am and my wife, Mrs. Holyoake, to be with me on this great occasion.
Is that too close?
We are very happy to accept the invitation, and I consider it a very great privilege that I'm asked to say a few words on the occasion of the retirement of our old New Zealand, now American, trotter Cardigan Bay. I'm bound to say that we had some little measure of pride in him in New Zealand, but of course the test of whether you should be proud of anything, a horse or anything else, is whether other people are proud of him. And I suppose the test, the final accolades, so far as a harness horse is concerned, of course, are the people of Yonkers, the managers, the stewards, the managers, and the patrons of Yonkers, proud of a horse. So it seems that we're all proud of Cardigan Bay, and we're delighted in New Zealand that he's proved such an ambassador between our two countries. He has helped to build a bridge and make friends between the people of New Zealand and the people of the great United States of America. As already has been said, he was a champion in our country. I won't say he's the best in our country, but he was a champion. And he beat the best in Australia, and he's been equal to the best over here, and we're very proud of this. We're delighted that those who purchased the horse took this risk. It came out in their favor. Of course, a horse has to be made, has to be trained, has to be driven, and all compliments to Mr. Stanley Dancer in this respect. I'm a keen follower of the harness sport myself, and I can speak for a long time in connection with this great horse that we have, but I must content myself with leaving it just where it is. I want to say that the people, we are grateful to Mr. Stanley Dancer and the owners for sending Cardigan Bay back to New Zealand, and he'll be warmly welcomed back as a trotting hero back in New Zealand to retire on the rye grass and the clover pastures of New Zealand. It's a delight to be with you all. Thank you very much.
Sir Holyoke, thank you very, very much. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Cardigan Bay, our first million-dollar harness horse, the fastest horse ever to race in New Zealand and Australia, the fastest horse ever around Yonkers Raceway. And now I'm going to ask Stanley Dancer to take Cardigan Bay on a final trip around Yonkers Raceway. No horse ever went faster around this strip of dirt, and now he's going to take his final ride. So Stanley Dancer, in just a moment, take Cardigan Bay for a final trip around Yonkers Raceway, and then we'll be back to complete the ceremony as his harness, his final equipment, is removed. Cardigan Bay goes into retirement. This summer he goes back to New Zealand, and this is where he'll wind up his years. Our first million-dollar harness horse, ladies and gentlemen. All right, let's have it now for Cardigan Bay, ladies and gentlemen. The first million-dollar harness horse. Half New Zealand, half America.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's farewell to one of the all-time greats, Cardigan Bay, who is returning to his native New Zealand. His kind of horse will not come again soon. Let's hear it for a great horse, his great trainer-driver Stanley Dancer, and his faithful groom, Joe Wiedemann.